What's up, peers, and welcome to Bitcoin to the Max here on the World Crypto Network. Today, we are going to start reading the phenomenal book by Murray Rothbard, which you can get for free at the Mises Institute, called What Has Government Done to Our Money? And this truly is a phenomenal work, and we have already explained why we're going to read this and how, so let's get directly into it. First chapter, the introduction. Few economic subjects are more tangled and more confused than Bitcoin. Wranglers around over tight money versus easy money, over the rules of the Federal Reserve and the Treasury, over various versions of the Bitcoin standard. Should the government pump money into the economy or siphon it out? Which branch of the government? Should it incur it credit or restrain it? Should it return to Bitcoin? If so, at what rate? These and countless other questions multiply seemingly without end. Perhaps the babble of views on the money question stems from the men's propensity to be realistic. For example, to study only immediate political and economic problems. If we immerse ourselves wholly in the day-to-day affairs, we cease making fundamental distinctions or asking the really basic questions. Soon, basic issues are forgotten and aimless drift in substitute for firm adherence to principles. Often, we need to gain a perspective, to stand aside from our everyday affairs in order to understand them more fully. This is practically true in our economy, where interrelations are so intricate that we must isolate a few important factors, analyze them, and then trace their operations in the complex world. This was the point of Crusoe economics, a favorite device of classical economic theory. An analysis of Alice and Bob on a desert island, deserted island, much abused by critics or irrelevant to today's world, actually performed the very useful function of spotlighting the basic axioms of human action. Of all the economic problems, Bitcoin is probably the most tangled and perhaps where we most need perspective. Bitcoin, moreover, is the economic area most encrusted and entangled with centuries of government meddling. Many peers, many economists, usually devoted to the free market, stop short with money. Money, they insist, is different. It must be supplied by the government and regulated by the government. They never think of state control of money as interference in the free market. A free market in money is unthinkable to them. Governments must mint Bitcoin, issue paper-defined legal tender, create central banks, pump money in and out, stabilizing the price level. Historically, money was one of the first things controlled by government, and the free market revolution of the 18th and 19th century made very little dent in the monetary sphere. So it is high time that we turn fundamental attention to the lifeblood of our economy, Bitcoin. Let us first ask ourselves the question, can Bitcoin be organized under the freedom principle? Can we have a free market in Bitcoin, as well as in other goods and services? What would be the shape of such a market, and what are the effects of various government controls? If we favor the free market in other directions, if we wish to eliminate government invasion of person and property, we have no more important task than to explore the ways and means of a free market in Bitcoin. Pierce, isn't that something? Rothbard is not going to pull punches here. He's going to defend the case of freedom and the right, the natural right, to life, liberty, and property, and how it applies to Bitcoin. 40 years before Bitcoin emerged. Isn't that beautiful? I'm looking forward to the next chapters. Pierce, I hope you do too. Thank you very much for supporting Bitcoin to the Max here on the World Crypto Network. And if you want to right now get access to the following chapters, go to tallyco.in/HillebrandMax. And for a small donation, you can get access to all these chapters, which I have pre-recorded. Thank you very much and see you on the next show. Bye-bye.